hybrid cross. But let's introduce some modern terminology so we can understand right away what's going on in his monohybrid cross without having to explain his cross with his terms and then go back and add the new terms in. Let's just add or talk about these modern terms now. So we have a gene, and one definition of a gene, this is pretty good, I found this on the internet, I like this definition. Unit of heredity, which is passed or transferred from parents to offspring and is held to determine some characteristic of the offspring. Now, okay, so that's our definition of a gene for now, and it's accurate, but as we'll see, we can have some other definitions when you get into the molecular part of the course. So with respect to character, let's say seed color and seed shape and plant height. Now, there is a gene in pea plants that controls seed color, and we'll call this the seed color gene, and one that controls seed shape. We'll call this the seed shape gene. And then we have a one that controls plant height. We'll call this the plant height gene. And there may be other genes involved, but the ones we're going to focus on, one for seed color, one for seed shape, one for plant height. And they don't have specific names, or maybe they do now, but we don't need to know what those names are. Now the trait, which is another word for phenotype, for seed color can be green or yellow. Now the green is the recessive phenotype, and the yellow is the dominant phenotype. And there will be a way you can figure these out when we look at the results of the cross, which is we'll be able to see which is recessive and which is dominant by looking at the results of the cross. Now for round and wrinkled, round is dominant, wrinkled is recessive. And for tall and dwarf, tall is dominant and dwarf is recessive. So now we need allele symbols. And so what alleles are is they are different versions of the same gene, and they may differ by one base pair or one nucleotide. We'll get to that again when we get to the molecular part of the course. For now, just know that alleles are different versions of the same gene, and we're going to use this certain method for symbolizing alleles at this part in the course, based on the recessive phenotype. So here we have the recessive phenotype is green. So we're going to use a small g to symbolize the allele that causes the green phenotype. Now the dominant version of the gene, the dominant allele of the gene that causes yellow, we are going to use a big G. So you can see the allele symbol is based on the recessive phenotype. The lowercase is for the recessive allele. The uppercase is for the dominant allele. Now we can see round is dominant, wrinkled is recessive. So little w for wrinkled, big W for round. Tall and dwarf, I can give you a second to think about that. What do you think is we're going to use for the symbol? Little d and big D. So big D for tall, little d for dwarf. Now, another term that's important. Let me see if this is, yes, we are still on camera. So genotype. Genotype is a list of alleles for a gene or multiple genes in an organism. So here's a genotype, two big G's, right? So P, plants, have two alleles for each gene. And this genotype, big G, big G, this means that P plant has two dominant alleles. Big G, little g. Okay, this other pea plant here has a big G allele and a little g allele. If we see this, this is a homozygous genotype. And we can say homozygous dominant because both alleles are dominant. This is heterozygous. And this is homozygous recessive, because it has two alleles that are the same and they're both recessive alleles. Now the phenotype up here is the physical manifestation of the genotype. So I'm running out of room here, but I just want to address that these guys right here are going to have the yellow phenotype, right? Because if you have one dominant allele, then you have the dominant phenotype. It's almost like that recessive allele isn't even there. And this genotype right here will have the recessive green phenotype. Now, let's take a look at Mendel's monohybrid cross.